So let's do a quick review of the order of operations. So let's recall the order of operations. Basically, we're just going to clarify a few things now that we're working with fractions on top of just integers. So let's say we have the order of operations, which is PEMDAS. And remember, parentheses stood, or the P stood for parentheses. And then later on, when we introduced absolute values, we said we're also going to treat absolute values as parentheses in that we're going to do them first. So it's parentheses or grouping symbols. And this is relevant here because, say, we have a fraction like 2 plus x over 3 plus 8. And we want to go ahead and simplify that. Well, we're going to have to write that as 2 plus x, group the top, and group the bottom together. So parentheses, the only reason we're revisiting is so that you understand to group the numerator and group the denominator when we have multiple numbers in the the numerator or the denominator. Exponents, let's just revisit that with fractions. And you can probably infer how to take care of exponents, but let me cover it anyway. So say you have something like 1 half cubed. How do I expand a half cubed? A half times a half times a half. And what's that?
One eighth.
The reason I bring this up is a lot of people get confused now that they know how to multiply fractions and add fractions. A lot of people leave the same denominator. And you don't leave the same denominator. You actually multiply everything straight across. So just keep that in mind when we're talking about exponents and fractions. Multiplication, we're going to do exactly the same as we've been doing before. Division. The only thing I want to bring up when we're talking about division is that a fraction is really just a division. So let's take a look at this example again. When we're looking at 2 plus x over 3 plus 8, we're going to treat the fraction bar as a division. So we're going to do it in the order that division comes in, which is after exponents if it comes before multiplication. And then finally, addition or subtraction stays the same. So let's try a couple of simple problems just to remember. So let's say we have 2/3 cubed minus 2. What should I do first according to the order of operations? Exponents. So if I do exponents first, that's 2/3 cubed. So let's do that here on the side. If I expand that, that's 2/3 times 2/3 times 2/3. What does that give me?
8/3.
Yes. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8, and 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. All right, so that was this right here. So this becomes 8 over 27 minus 2. Now what do I do?
Subtract.
So what do I need to do to subtract these two fractions? LCD. What is the LCD? So I need to multiply the second number by 27. So this becomes 8 over 27 minus 2 times 27 over 27. 2 times 27. Yeah, 54, and 8 minus 54, negative 46 over 27, okay, that's my final answer because I can't reduce that anymore. Actually, can I? I think I can. It's 46 is 7 times 2 times 3. 27 is 3 times 3 times 3, so I can reduce it by 3. It becomes negative 14 over 9. Let's try one more. evaluate negative 3/5 minus xy if x equals 3/10 and y equals 2/3. So it's really the same type of problem. Instead of x and y, I'm just going to put parentheses in there. This is going to be helpful if you have negative numbers that you're plugging in. And then where the x was, I'm just going to plug in 3/10. And where the y was, I'm going to plug in 2/3. Okay, what do I take care of first?
Parentheses.
Inside the parentheses, I don't really have anything. So I have to just assume that there are no parentheses because there's nothing I can do inside them. So multiplication comes next. Okay? I want to multiply these two. I can multiply and then reduce, or I can reduce before I multiply. I'm going to do it before. So these 3's cancel out, and the 2 goes into 10 5 times. So this becomes negative 3/5 minus 1/5. And the only thing left is subtraction. So when I subtract those two, what do I get?
Negative
4/5. There are multiple correct answers. Which are correct in that list of answers? Let me ask you, which is not correct? The last one. Why is the last one not correct? Right, so in this case, I have a negative divided by a positive, so it comes out to be a negative. In this case, I have a positive divided by a negative, so it comes out to be a negative. And in this case, I have a negative divided by a negative, which would come out positive. So this is not the same as all the others. But all the others are exactly the same. And we did that last lecture.